Here are true facts about coin cleaning. Since the dawn of time, mankind has wondered, what is the most efficient way to clean coins? The answer? Unnecessarily elaborate contraptions constructed from children's toys. To start, you'll need a coin, preferably a dirty one, like this one. Look at it, it's filthy. You have a clean one, you don't need to be doing this. Go play outside or something. First, you will need a Bluetooth speaker. The speaker, when activated, will shake a Jenga block off of it, sending it towards a white, round, foamy thing. The ladder of a fire truck is extended so that the round, foamy thing rolls off of it and into a lever. The lever releases a stopper which is currently preventing this shoddily constructed toy car with prongs sticking out of it from moving, because it has wheels, and wheels roll when there's nothing stopping them from doing that. When the stopper is released, the car will roll down this ramp. The pronged vehicle will smack a minecart, which will roll down this wooden track into a line of dominoes, as well as these Jenga blocks that are posing as dominoes, because everyone was doing it and they wanted to be popular. These dominoes will hit another minecart, which will roll down another wooden track and smack into this pink orb. The pink orb will then roll into a tiny silver marble, which will then roll into this marble cannon, launching his friend into this trampoline, which is surrounded by lights for some reason. Good for visibility, I guess. Marble will land in this plastic funnel thingy, which will lead into this tube. Watch out for this beam here. After emerging from the tube, the marble will nudge this poking device, which will nudge another pink orb. This orb will roll into a plug, which will switch on a nearby fan. That electric orb there has nothing to do with anything, but it does look pretty cool. The fan will blow this empty orange crush bottle into this pillar thing. The pillar has a long string tied to it. Seriously, look how long this thing is. Just keeps going. It's like it doesn't end at all. On the other end of the long string is another orange crush bottle? What? Once pulled, the orange crush bottle will set off yet another line of dominoes. I told you, everyone was doing it. The dominoes in one Jenga block will set off a small blue sphere. The sphere will roll into a tiny marble at the end of this wooden track. The marble will travel down this long tower of cubes. At the bottom of this tower, surprise, surprise, more dominoes. These dominoes, and wannabe dominoes, when set off, why is there another orange crush bottle? Will knock over this platform, upon which is resting the dirty coin. The coin will drop into the water, cleaning it completely. You know, probably. It's just water. If you're wondering why we didn't just drop the coin into the tank ourselves, don't ask stupid questions. This spider has nothing to do with the machine. Leave him alone. He did nothing to you. Don't be a jerk. Also, this light here. Leave it on. You kinda need that to see. This particular machine is powered by a certain song. Apparently, that song is REM's Orange Crush. Oh no, those bottles make sense. Here you can see the final result. The coin, which was filthy before, is now sparkly and shiny, almost like a whole new coin. But it's not. It was that filthy, dirty one. Honestly, looking at the before and after, I can't see much difference. But nevertheless, the coin was dunked in water and it had to do something, right? I mean, if it didn't, this was all pointless. So remember, if you ever have a dirty coin, all you need to do to clean it, build an elaborate contraption. Or just use soap or something. It's just a coin. I find now time to serve your conscience.
Ah!